So you guys were one. I'm hearing all you guys. You guys wanted a theme song shortened, so here we go. This girl views movies, games, and books. Sometimes she plays them. So does that, and when she does it with the cat, does that make her crazy? Does that make her crazy? Probably. So, it's shorter. There you go. Crazy Cat Lady, or Martha Butler, does not own any trailers or pictures. I use them under fair use, educational, for education and entertainment purpose.
Alright, hi everyone, Martha here, so part 3 of Green, of Stray God. See what happens next. That was... because Stephanie tried to kiss us, and I know what happens, but... so I gotta go and see what that was about. But she walked, she said no. Didn't do it.
You've returned. I'm glad. I've had time to do some thinking. After Aphrodite's party, we never really spoke about the Eidolon and Calliope's memories. No doubt you have many questions. Apollo told me a little about it. He did say I should talk to you, though. Did he now? Is there anything you'd like to ask? How many times have you died? Can I ask that? We call it passing on. I've lost track of just how many times I've passed on my Eidolon. A dozen? It's happened less often in more recent eras. And the one you told me about, the woman married to that gangster, she was the most recent? I don't think of chastity as a she. That was me, just as the one my husband blasted with a shotgun was also me. It was one of the few times I wasn't able to prepare my successor. We were friends, yes, but I didn't know what Persephone was, and I had no idea what I'd just become. That must have been difficult. It was more difficult taking over my dead husband's territory. Women weren't often mobsters in those days. When all these memories start to return, will I feel different? First, you'll have dreams. Places you've never been, people you've never met. But unlike with normal dreams, these will linger. Then they will come while you're awake. Sudden flashes or snippets of deja vu. And sometimes it will seem so real you'll swear you're hallucinating. If there's anything difficult about the process, is that it becomes hard to differentiate between your life and all these other lives you're now recalling.
It does sound confusing.
Confusing and often unpleasant. As not all the memories will be fond ones. But that will pass in time.
You said it becomes hard to differentiate your life from the others. How hard, exactly? It'll still be me, right?
Oh, how do I explain this? Greece, would you say that you are who you are because of your experiences? The things you've lived and done?
I guess so, sure.
Well, all the things Calliope has done, and those before her, will now be yours. They will feel like a part of your life as well. Thus, they can't help but shape you. The Grace that is now will be and will have done so much more. Fortunately, you don't have to deal with every memory. Each time the Eidolon passes on, the oldest memories fade, and that helps.
Wait, how is it good that old memories start to fade?
Think of how old we are, Grace. If all those memories returned to you with perfect clarity, they would destroy you.
Yeah, but doesn't that mean you've all forgotten so much?
Well, far more than we remember. The further I think back, the more it becomes a bit of a blur, actually. You'll recall important moments. Some will be mixed up with the stories mortals tell, and you won't be sure which is the memory and which is the story. An idol's memory is a series of islands in a dark ocean, and they become smaller and smaller as they recede into the horizon. It sounds dire, but you become accustomed to it. It just takes time, and now you have all the time in the world.
Were you really a gangster? I've heard it said, but it sounds... Let me put it this way. I felt as if I'd been blessed by a dying woman who saved me from a prison of my own making. I didn't know what I was, but I was free. I felt more alive than I'd ever felt before, and strong enough to toss an ox 10 feet. Did I set out to become a mobster? Not exactly. My husband's friends thought I'd murdered him, however, so they came after me. And one thing led to another. Oh, I see. Athena found me just as my memories were starting to return. I wasn't permitted to continue doing something so noticeable, so I was carted off to Olympus. It's too bad, really. I was an excellent mobster. Wait, you said that Persephone passed on her Eidolon as she lay dying. What if she had just died? The Eidolon will keep us alive for a time, even in the most horrific circumstances, in hopes that there's someone to pass it on to. What if there isn't? What if Chastity had died before you were shot? Then the line of Persephone would have ended then and there. Oh, there are some stories that say an Eidolon will go wandering, that it never really dies. And who knows if there's any truth to that. It's not exactly something we've had the opportunity to study. All we know is that many idols have left us forever. They've died, and that's how it happens. It's a lot to consider. Assuming I'll even have time to worry about it, what with the trial coming. Either the trial will end poorly, in which case all of this is moot, or it will end well, and you will have plenty of time to digest. Yeah, thanks for the update. I'm a realist, Grace. It's what I'm best at. Now then, unless you've something else to ask. What's the deal between you and Apollo? The way you two fight. I've told you how he and the other idols stood by and let me rot with Hades, did I not? It seems more personal than that. Okay, there's an old saying that no one escapes the underworld. But that's not true. I did. Once. Not long after Hades kidnapped me. I was homesick. And I missed my mother. Caron took pity on me and allowed me across the Styx. And after that, Grace, I waded through darkness itself to get out of there. Hades chased after me relentlessly, but I evaded him, right up until I got to the very slopes of Olympus, and who do you suppose was the first idol I met? Uh-oh. Apollo stood there. I cried out to him, begging him not to let Hades take me, and yet Apollo did, as he has always done, absolutely nothing. Hades was thrilled. And I knew then and there I could never rely on my so-called family for anything, ever again.
How do you not know when you come?
Psst. Isn't it strange to not know where you come from? For all you know, the idols could be aliens.
Aliens? Grace, you watch too many movies.
Gods are okay, but aliens are just wacky fiction.
Fine, yes. It is strange. Well, our earliest days aren't the only blanks in our memories, however. We have many. And the last was the day Zeus called us all together to tell us Rome had fallen and we should prepare for war. But did that war occur? I couldn't tell you. The last thing I remember after Rome was 1,000 years later, in the 16th century. I was in a different body, feeling as if no time at all had passed. Athena calls that period the gap. That's what it feels like. All of us experienced it, and not one of us knows why or how.
That's all I can think of for now. I'll see you around.
Oh, yes. That's where I'll be. Around.
Hey, hey! So what's the news, Miss Muse?
Miss Muse?
Well, does a muse have a proper form of address? I just want to hear what exciting adventures you've been having.
Well, I went to a party held by the goddess of love, and she died.
Man, I always miss the really good parties. Here I was, sitting at home, just reading a book. Everything else okay, though? Do we know who the killer is yet?
Not just yet, no.
Okay, well, let me know if there's anything I can do. If I have to hustle to become your high priestess, well, so be it.
You know what I find weird? That the idols have managed to remain completely secret all these years. Sure, they have magic and whatnot, but in all this time, nobody's found them out? Athena is that good?
Who says nobody has found them out? The way I see it, it's like UFOs.
Okay, I have to hear this.
Okay, so you have real evidence that UFOs exist and that governments have covered it up and people still wouldn't believe it. Why? Because they'd get laughed at if they admitted it. Imagine the headline, Greek gods exist and are living among us. What website would even run that?
Weird conspiracy ones. Yeah, you're right. Okay, that's enough questions for now.
You sure? I could talk all day, you know I can.
I'll check back with you soon, Freddy. Time for more mystery solving. This must be the Viper's Nest. Scariest part of town, no sign. Just that one dude glaring at everyone. Oh, I'm here now. Just another day in the life of an idol.
Oh, there you are. Man, this place is the worst. I think someone peed on me.
Freddy? What are you doing here?
What, you thought I wouldn't notice you skulking off? You didn't even bring any equipment, Grace.
Freddy, please tell me you don't think you're some kind of adventurer.
I'm sorry. Are you not about to head into a monster's lair at great personal peril? What else would you call that?
You're such a dork. I adore you.
Good, because I'm not about to let you wander in there without backup. Who knows? Maybe the stuff I know about Medusa might actually apply. Well, that'd be a switch.
Okay, I'll bite. What do you know about Medusa?
Well, you know, she was human once, right?
Yes.
She was cursed.
Apollo mentioned it, yeah.
Cursed by Athena. Or so one of the stories goes, anyway.
But doesn't she work for Athena?
Hey, don't look at me. My knowledge of this stuff stops at a few thousand years ago.
Do you think she actually turns people to stone?
Let's hope not, or this could be a short visit.
Or a really, really long one.
I'm serious! Perseus used a mirror to reflect Medusa's gaze back at her. Oh, maybe you could use your phone. Grace,
I never thought of that! Let's use our phone!
She was once human, but she's definitely a monster, right?
Yeah, one of the worst. But, you know, so was the Minotaur.
Asterion said she was scary. I have a feeling she's not like him.
Then I guess you need to be prepared for the possibility that she's as bad as the legends say. Though some of the stories also say that she was wronged by Athena and that what was done to her was an injustice.
And Athena just follows the rules, right? Okay, enough talking. Time to do this.
You have a plan for how we're getting inside, I hope.
Maybe. You're here to help?
Always.
Then I have a plan. Nothing in your bag for bashing a lock, I take it?
I thought this was an adventure, not break and enter.
What do you think adventures are, Freddy?
I still can't believe you could do that. It's like I don't even know you. And is this a good idea? What if Medusa, like, called the cops?
Why would she?
As I recall, your big idea was to distract the guy at the front door with firecrackers. They're legal and loud. Do I even want to know what else is in there? Oh, but it's probably better if you don't. And there we go. Coming? Oh, hell yes. I wouldn't miss this for the world. Time to split up and have a look around.
Thank you. Not done your homework.
Oh, sorry, just trying to get your attention.
Yeah, shouldn't she be turned to stone?
And
she's
I'm
not.
I'm willing to bet you can't turn me to stone before I burn your snakes off. Freddy, you made it. Who's making fun of the adventure pack now? I've got two more cans where this came from. You ready to talk?
Fine. Fine. What exactly is it that you want, pretty muse?
Oh, come on. You really can't guess? You're smarter than that.
Blast! This is why I didn't tell Lady Athena. I knew it would come back to haunt me. I only followed pretty Calliope to the reliquary. I never spoke to her, never even caught up to her. I swear it.
That's what Asterion told us, more or less. But you were there that night.
Yes, yes, I admit it.
Franny should be stoned! Franny to be stoned!
Mounted on a pike. Whatever you might think of me, I had no part in the muse's death. I did not even know she'd been attacked until I saw her fleeing.
You haven't told Athena any of this? Do I need to light things up again? Cause I'll do it.
I told her Calliope was at the reliquary that night. I did not tell her I was also there.
Why not? Wouldn't Athena find out from Hecate anyway?
I was not thinking clearly. I panicked. Lady Athena barely tolerates my presence as it is. If she thought I was involved in any way, if she even suspected.
You followed Calliope to the reliquary. Why were you shadowing her at all?
I am Lady Athena's spymaster, yes. Calliope has been trouble from time to time.
So you were spying on her?
I keep watch over every idol who no longer lives in Olympus, but especially Calliope. When I realized she was headed to the reliquary that eve, I followed. I had a duty to Athena.
Asterion said he caught up with you out in the fog. Is that right?
I thought he was the one who had attacked her. He is a great beast of a creature.
He killed Hecate's cat by accident. But this still seems hard to believe.
Yes, I only realized my mistake once I caught up to him, and by then the muse was gone.
And you never found her afterwards?
I thought she might flee to her pretty home, or to the shop in Prickly Persephone. She did neither.
Yeah, she came to see me. Why should we believe you? You did just try to eat me, remember?
I am telling you the truth.
Right, and not at all trying to cover your own ass.
You presented an opportunity. To taste the sweet, sweet blood of a hero once again. It's a problem. I've been working on it, I really have.
Uh-huh.
Well, what of that? The only reason I knew Calliope was going to the reliquary is because he informed me.
So much for never lying to me. Or the odds, honestly. Let's put a pin in that for the moment, shall we?
I am a monster. It's true, I do not deny it. But still, I did not kill the muse.
Okay, let's say we believe you. For the moment.
Whatever you do, Pretty Muse, I beg you. Do not tell Athena of my indiscretion. Show mercy. I know what I am horrifies you. It horrifies me as well. I cannot help what I am. I did not ask to be cursed like this.
I know. You were the R word.
Indiscretion, huh? It's quite the word for it.
I cannot apologize for my hunger. I can only apologize that I am so very weak in the face of it.
Oh, think about it.
I am a lost and cursed thing. No idol. If Lady Athena should learn the truth, I hope you find what you seek, Pretty Muse. And that we meet again someday. And sing a different song.
He knew. Right from the start, Pan knew Calliope was there that night.
Yeah,
and who could have foreseen that he was lying to you the entire time? Who, I ask you, a mystery even the Oracle couldn't have penetrated. There could be a good explanation. Oh, Grace, just so sweet, so willing to see the best in everyone. Anyhow, you probably have a few questions for Mr. Goatman. I'll see you at home. Would you really have tried to burn Medusa's face off with an aerosol can? Hell yeah! One hit of googly eyes and... What would I do without you? You'll never need to answer that question, Grace.
Oh, if it isn't, the lovely Grace?
You knew. Right from the start, you knew Calliope was there that night.
Well, yes. She asked for the key and I gave it to her, no questions asked. I told you I didn't know what happened to Calliope, and that's the truth. I did not. So I nudged you in the right direction.
And lied about why?
I omitted things, yes. I was rather hoping to avoid suspicion falling my way.
I've never lied to you, Grace, and I never shall.
Medusa learned that Calliope was going to the reliquary. Because I told her. Now, before you say anything, I had no idea of the fate awaiting our dear muse. And you yourself said Medusa was not responsible. I simply had to know if I'd inadvertently, rather innocently...
Sold her out? She came to you for help, and you gave her whereabouts to the highest bidder.
I am trying to help, Grace. In my way.
What do you mean, in my way? What way is that?
The way where I don't take all the blame.
What else will I discover, Pan? I'd rather learn it now than later.
I wish I could tell you, Grace. I truly do.
Back again so soon, Grace? You're practically a regular at the club. Did you end up finding Medusa? Or did she vanish the moment you came near, like she does with every other idol?
She definitely did not vanish. Maybe I better explain what happened.
Blah, 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 blah.
I knew it. We never should have brought that monster to the new world. Athena is a fool to think Medusa can be controlled. You were fortunate to have made it out in one piece. It could have gone very poorly for you.
You're right. I should have brought you to protect little old defenseless me.
Aw. If I'd gone, you would have found nothing more than an empty building, I assure you.
Because you're so big and scary.
I'm glad you appreciate my finer qualities.
At any rate, Medusa might be in the clear. Pan, however, is not.
I don't imagine you've confronted him yet.
He admitted to selling out Calliope, but not to killing her. I don't know if I can believe him.
Nor I. Pan would do anything to save his own skin. Allow me some time to consider our next move. Now then, unless you've something else to ask?
No, not really. I'll see you later, Persephone.
All right.
Hi, Grace. I can just call you Grace, right?
That's my name. Where's Freddy?
She went out to get snacks. We were gonna watch TV while we waited, but, well, here you are.
Waited? Were you looking for me?
All over, yeah. Athena sent me to find you, but it wasn't easy. Yeah, you must have been busy.
Yeah, because I stand trial soon.
Right. Right, that makes sense. Anyway, I guess Athena wants to talk? I can zip us over to Olympus anytime, if you're free.
I suppose there's no point in putting it off. You do your thing. Take me to Olympus.
Okay. Oh, when you see Freddy, tell her I'm sorry I couldn't stick around for the movie. And mind if I say something?
Sure.
You've changed. I mean, from the person I met when I first came here. When, you know, you got it together really quick.
Thanks, I guess.
Fine, let me do calm. Well, I think charming. I guess I do kick ass.
There you are, Grace. Do have a seat. I prefer to stand, thanks.
As you like.
You've certainly been busy, haven't you? Everywhere I turn, there you are, including the reliquary.
Oh.
I'm uncertain how you got access, but even you must have realized it's off limits, particularly for your mortal friend. Sorry to be annoying.
I'm not annoyed, my dear. I'm concerned what new trouble you'll find in attempting to escape your old trouble.
Oh, well, I'll try to die more quietly next time.
You think our judgment was rash? It was. In truth, I worried that giving you time, letting us all get to know you, would make it harder in the end. I am sorry, Grace. You may not believe it, but I care deeply. I care about what happens to you and to all the idols.
Do you really? Let's explore where all that caring has gotten them, shall we? You're holding on with a grip so tight, your knuckles are turning white. But that's not enough, is it? Every idol I've met is either lost or broken, or both. They're all slipping through your fingers. If you actually cared about them, you'd do something about it instead of sitting up here worrying about your precious rules.
Zeus was the first to leave, king of the gods, and we don't even know what became of him. Vanished into the ether. Poseidon was next, walked out into the seas, never to be heard from again. Ares betrayed us. Hephaestus saved us. Hades was murdered, and by one of our own. The list goes on.
So you add to it. I show up and you kill me off because you can't be too careful.
We are dying, Grace. I don't mean diminishing or drifting apart. I mean our immortality is disappearing. Very soon now, the idols will be no more. We are a legacy that spans millennia, dating back to the very dawn of humankind. So yes, I care. I will do anything and everything in my power to avoid that fate, even if it appears unfair.
That's it? That's what you have to say? Sorry, we're gonna kill you, but things are dire. Things are tough all over, Athena. Do you really think clamping down on your rules will make it better?
Those rules are our last line of defense against chaos, dear. I know we've put a great deal on your shoulders, Grace. I do. All I called you here to ask is that you please not make my job more difficult than it already is. If you have any other questions or concerns, now's the time to bring them up.
I guess I'll get back to my investigation.
I am rooting for you, Grace. If there's another way to resolve this, any way at all, I will take it.
Will you? Really?
Good luck. Feel free to take a cookie on your way out.
She never does, though.
Don't take it personally, Grace. Athena's first instinct is to follow the rules whenever things get rough. As if she believes that if the idols don't blindly follow every rule to the letter, we'll dissolve into utter chaos.
Well, is she right?
Probably.
Isn't it much, dragging me into her office just to complain about the investigation she forced me into? What could she hope to achieve? That I'd stop trying?
Maybe she just wanted to find out what you know. I imagine she simply wanted to remind you not to rock the boat as you bail. At any rate, I'm afraid we're going to have to disappoint her again.
Uh-oh, what now?
You need to go back to the reliquary, Grace.
Even though Athena specifically warned me not to?
That'll go over well. The one thing we do not yet know is why Calliope went to the reliquary in the first place.
Okay, I'll bite. How would I find that out? You think she left clues?
We can't ask Calliope what her plan was. But you might be able to remember what she was doing there.
Her memories?
But I thought that it will take years, yes. But if you go somewhere important to Calliope, or touch something special to her, you'll get flashes, feelings.
You want Grace to go to the reliquary so she can have deja vu?
I'm willing to wager the place Calliope met her fate has left its mark in Grace's psyche. We have only to uncover it.
Last time Freddy and I were there, Hecate wouldn't let us into the reliquary. Not without Athena's permission.
I'm certainly not suggesting we ask Athena for permission.
Then you mean...
A week ago, I would have said breaking into the reliquary was impossible. Yet it appears Hecate can be surprised. If her book says, she will be.
Well, let's hope the book says that again, I guess.
Unless you've some other plan. I'm all ears, as they say.
Right then. Back to the reliquary it is.
Any idea how you want to do this, Grace? Because I'm game to help.
Cool. I'm sure we can figure something out.
I can't go in with you. Hecate would sense me right away. I will, however, stay close by. If anything happens, I'll come. Hecate won't stop me. The Minotaur won't stop me. Nothing will.
That's great to know, but I'll try not to make it necessary.
Ugh, can we just get on with this already?
Hopefully, I can get do this one this time without killing Freddy.
Ah, so that is now. Oh, you were expecting us? I just written that you would come. Yes.
That is so cool. I kid you not.
Yet it was also written that you would sneak into the reliquary, as Calliope did, so this encounter is... unanticipated. This book of yours really isn't as accurate as you make it out to be.
The course it lays out is almost always correct. The smaller things, they are subject to free will and frequently change. However, even without the book, I do understand why you've come. Is there a reason why you believe my answer will be different now? Didn't I make you and the Minotaur, well, happier?
You did. It is pleasant. Isn't that worth anything?
This was true when you were here last, and yet I still considered my duty paramount.
I guess it can't be that pleasant.
My happiness is irrelevant. I am grateful for all you have done, but my purpose here cannot be so easily cast aside.
Asterion said you don't know why Calliope was here, or what she did.
That is correct.
Don't you want to? Are you the least bit curious?
You could say it's your duty to find out, at least so it doesn't happen again, right?
That... is an argument not entirely without merit.
Then let me try. I'll accept whatever conditions you want, Hecate. I'm begging you.
You will regret this. That is also written.
That is a yes.
Go quickly. Look, but do not touch. The reliquary stores many artifacts, some dangerous.
Got it. Okay, Grace, what the heck do you do now? Of all the times to not have Freddy around, she'd love this. First things first, how do I do this? Where do I even start? Calliope must have been here.
Why she
could have stood in this Simba. Very spot. Maybe if I just focus. Weird, like I've definitely been here before.
So let me look in the mirror first.
Shouldn't that be in a museum somewhere? Is this an armory too? They should really charge for tours. It's kind of amazing. Freddy say about mazes? Was it always go left? Or go left and then go right?
There it is.
This is it. Calliope was here. She was standing right here. And she... Suppose there's any chance you'll put those knives away. Okay, then. What's happening? Why didn't it work?
There's no preventing it.
Freddy! We've gotta run! My powers don't work on them, they just keep coming!
Yeah, this is no preventing it. Which direction to go? I guess she does die. Darn you. It's made more sense for her to die in the other one because she's still in the maze, but she could have stayed with Hecate this time around.
Oh god, Freddy! By the gods, you summoned the Furies. What? Those beings were the Furies, beyond all our laws. Not idols, but the embodiment of retribution. How did you draw them here? I didn't! There was a big mirror, but I didn't even touch it! There was only one mirror of which you could be speaking. That used by the goddess Nyx to contact the Fates. Using the mirror would not have brought the Furies down upon you. Not unless the Fates themselves decreed it. I didn't talk to any Fates. There were figures in the mirror, but they vanished when the Furies got there. This was no defense or spell of the reliquaries. I do not have the power to summon the Furies, and I know none who do. You should consider yourself fortunate, Grace. They do not desist until retribution has been exacted. But now is when you leave. Pray the knowledge you obtained was worth the price. How can you say that? I didn't mean for this to happen! Your intentions are irrelevant, Grace. All choices have consequences. I didn't choose this! I wouldn't have let her... Come. There's nothing more to be done.
Act 3.
I'm sorry it came to this, Grace. It's clear what your friend meant to you.
It should have been me, not her.
Don't say that.
This was my fight, my problem. I'm already slated to die if anyone paid the price.
Your friend gave you the chance to not repeat history. Don't waste it. Grace, is that how Calliope died? Was she also attacked by the Furies? Do you remember?
Yeah. She meant to use the mirror, but she never had the chance before. Before they came.
No doubt sent by the same person. Perhaps for the same reason.
Who could send the Furies after me? Even Hecate had no idea who possessed that kind of power.
No one does, not these days. Hecate herself would have been my guess. Zeus might have, in his role as king of old Olympus, but he is long gone.
Clearly someone can do it.
Unless they weren't summoned. They could have been responding to something you did unwittingly, something Calliope also did. Now what that could be? I'm afraid I have no clue.
I know Calliope was there to use the mirror, but it was just feeling. I still don't understand why.
There's only one use for that mirror, to speak to the Fates.
Yeah, okay, but why?
The Fates know all that is or will be. Destiny is theirs to command, or so it's said. One contacts them either to know one's fate or to change it. Not that the Fates are likely to oblige.
I don't know what to do. We still have no idea why Calliope wanted to talk to the Fates.
Well, there is another way to ask them.
I wondered how long that would take. Hecate is enraged. She's threatened to close off the reliquary entirely and forever. Athena is beside herself.
Ah! We're surprised that you're there!
Long enough. You just had to keep pushing, didn't you? until you got what you wanted.
This isn't about me. We're out of options, Apollo, and you know there's only one other way to contact the Fates.
Oh, how convenient.
Enough, both of you. This isn't helping anyone.
May I explain it to Grace, or do you have another option, Apollo? If so, now's the time. I thought not. The Fates will respond to the ruler of Hades, the true underworld and realm of the dead. What I propose is that we go there and take back the throne that was stripped from me.
How do we get to Hades? Do we need a key, like the reliquary?
Athena took my key, and the entrance at Lake Avernus was sealed long ago, which leaves only armies.
They won't take you.
They might, if you ask them to. Then why did you come, Apollo? To gloat? To wish Grace well? Or to actually help? Get us there. I'll lead us to the throne, and Grace can speak with the Fates. It's simple.
Is that something we can do? Just go to the land of the dead and overthrow it?
Truth be told, there isn't much to overthrow. Few mortals still believe in Hades, and thus its halls have been nearly empty for eons.
So how do you...
The throne itself is the key, both symbolically and literally. Claim it, and Hades is yours.
But you can't claim it because you're barred from Hades.
By a rule that we would need to break were we to do this, yes.
So if we go to Hades and find your throne, how much trouble would that get us into exactly?
A great deal.
It's not as if Athena could execute Grace a second time.
But she's already been warned about breaking more rules.
The responsibility of this will be mine. Let Athena try to take my throne again.
Is there really no other way to talk to these Fates? Do we have to take the nuclear option?
Do you want to try going back to the reliquary?
No. No. Hell no.
The only other person with a direct connection to the Fates is Apollo here.
You know it doesn't work like that.
Then it's the throne or nothing, isn't it?
Okay. No need to keep selling me on it. I'm in.
You are?
Yeah. I need to punch something really hard. Or overthrow hell. I'm good with either of those things.
Did you see that, Apollo? You see, that is what a backbone looks like.
I can't. I'm sorry, but this is a step too far.
And consider this, Apollo. Grace's mortal friend was slain by the Furies. According to the old laws,
her soul is in Hades.
Wait, what? You said Hades was empty.
Your friend may, in fact, be the first new soul to enter its halls in many years.
And thus could leave it. Fine. I'll meet you in Hades. But I'm not going with you.
If that's what you prefer, by all means.
Let's find armies. Get this over with.
Shall I wait here, or...?
No, no. I'm not gonna lie to them. Hermes has always treated me fairly.
Oh, hey, if it isn't Apollo and Grace, and, Persephone. Wow, the whole gang, huh?
I'm afraid I have to call in that favor. I need you to take Grace and Persephone to Hades.
Oh, man, I don't know. Athena specifically said I wasn't supposed to take anyone, you know? No matter what.
Oh, this is pointless. They're never gonna help us, Apollo.
Can I ask what's going on? Nobody ever tells me anything, and you want me to get in huge trouble, but for what?
Come on, Hermes. How much trouble would you be in, really? What's Athena gonna do? Leave Olympus? Get her own dry cleaning? She needs you more than you need her.
Yeah, but Athena works so hard, and it's always for everyone else.
Sounds like someone else I know. Isn't there anything that you want, Hermes?
Oh. What I want is the truth.
That's what I want too. The truth. You don't believe I killed Calliope, right?
No, I don't.
Then help me. Trust me. That's all I'm asking.
Okay. Signal when you need to come back.
You sure?
Yeah, feels like the right thing.
Be careful, Grace. And remember, the underworld doesn't give up its shades without a price.
I think I can tell her the rules, Apollo. Let's go. Welcome to the real underworld.
Wow. It feels so empty. So lonely.
It's not completely empty. Neither is the throne, for that matter. A bitter shade named Orpheus has been squatting on it since my exile. I fully expect he'll be waiting for us.
So there's gonna be a fight? Good. I need something to punch.
Don't get too excited, Grace. Orpheus is hardly a worthy foe.
Really? Even though he took your throne?
He took an empty throne after I left. That does not make him a king. Just someone else that's in my way.
In our way, you mean?
Yes, in our way.
Who is this Orpheus? The name sounds familiar.
It should. His is a popular tale among mortals regarding how he once came to the underworld to retrieve his love, Eurydice, and left with nothing. Hades tricked him, you see. And with Hades dead, the blame has evidently fallen to me.
So he's not.
You didn't know anything to do with it. It was all Hades' decision to do that to him.
No. Not that it matters.
Okay, so there's an angry ghost sitting on your throne. Anything else about this trip you've neglected to mention?
Come. It's time to cross the Styx. The ferryman will come soon. As we are not dead, you will need to convince him you are worthy of passage. State your case clearly and with determination. I am Persephone, also known as Despoina and Core Sotiera, once queen of the underworld, and shall be again. No, Caron, I did not bring you any cards. I am not here to entertain you.
name is Grace, and I'm here to save my friend Freddy. Have you seen her?
He says he has. She spoke a great deal as they crossed the river, and that made him very happy.
Happy? Why happy?
I don't imagine Carol gets much company these days, Grace. No, no, she didn't. Neither of us brought games to play with you, Carone. Stop asking.
Has he, always been like this?
Once he was as grim as the grave itself. Time has clearly eroded his gravitas. And it appears I'll have to find Cerberus as he's gotten himself lost. Wonderful.
Yay, Cerberus!
Let's get underway, Carone. It's a long ride to the throne room.
Like the fact that he mentioned Cerberus. We don't get to see him, though.
I wouldn't touch that. Way too much for you. Overlong you. Blow a fuse. Every storm. Every memory. Winds up here. In the water. I used to dream that this river would rise, swallow the tears in my eyes, then suddenly I was found. I destroyed things, I was denied his throne.
Her queen.
We're here for Freddy, too.
I killed the king fair and square. They had no right to take it from me.
There was no right or wrong. It wasn't your fault. You didn't belong. If my life was stolen, I wouldn't know where to turn. The candle isn't finished. It's a slow burn.
Someone's coming. There's music floating through. Someone's coming. It has me singing too. We have visitors. I think we all know what to do. To the throne room. This bard's about to meet a muse.
There's someone singing with us.
That would be Orpheus.
Is he a muse?
Oh, he's so much more than that.
Someone's coming.
You better be ready.
A wolf is waiting in the
chair. He's a master of his craft. We have to take back.
I can feel them howling at the
what is mine.
Don't forget why we came here.
There's a name here.
I won't forget.
That leaks.
But you can bet he knows someone's coming.
I have been waiting for you, Persephone, for so long. And you brought a muse.
Hi.
Lovely Tim, by the way. Can't remember the last time I collaborated with someone so talented. No offense, Tim. Welcome to my underworld. Let me treat you to a song, a welcome gift. I had the floor. It is mine, after all. Muse, any requests? Questions?
Are you really that good?
Dude, get out now. I wouldn't say that I'm good. I wouldn't say that I'm great. I wouldn't say that my timing's perfect. I wouldn't say that I'm late. But you can see that he's the best that's ever been. The best you've ever seen. The best you've ever heard. And I haven't even really said a single word.
I think I chose poorly.
Okay, just get in the cage. Not your thing? Try again. Another request.
What's your problem with Persephone?
Down, down, down. Loop it. Down, down, down. I didn't do what I was told, didn't know that it was all a game. I didn't think that he would do it. And Eurydice was gone. And Persephone is like a
sign. You shouldn't look behind you, dude. Don't you never what happened? It was your fault. What were you gonna do against Hades? You're not a god!
It wasn't your fault. How were you to react? It wasn't your fault. Now there's no turning back. If my love was taken, I wouldn't know where to turn. Your candle isn't finished. It's a slow burn.
This time the ten is over. If he's the victim, what am I?
Queen, let's not lose our composure. The muse understands.
Well, I won't comply. I'd rather die. The throne was stolen. After I murdered the king, you should be grateful and thank me for everything. And yet you scream like a boy, you kick the ground. I was a slave.
Mercy is gone because you did nothing.
Orpheus, there was nothing I could do. I saw your whispers
poison behind your king.
It wasn't me.
If I cannot have my revenge, you're the next best thing.
Orpheus, instead of a life of despair, Hades will avenge it there. This place will still be humming.
Oh, I rather doubt that.
Does it make it any less true?
Am I the one on trial now?
It wasn't your fault. You were never to blame. Hades was a monster. Part of his game. Orpheus, where's your fire? Music return.
Candles you fished.
It's a snowball.
The throne doesn't belong to you, and you know it.
If I didn't do what I was told, I'd be dragged across the palace floor. Hades can't hurt us anymore. Eurydice is still gone. For what it's worth, you've my apology. But I assure you, nothing more. For deep down you know that there's no revenge.
The pain never ends.
The pain never ends.
There's no revenge.
This was never gonna end the way you wanted to. And I won't
turn my back. I won't turn my back on you again.
I had forgotten how sweet a melody could be. Such thoughts become clouded in this place. Forgive me, my lady of the night.
An empty chair for an empty kingdom. Don't tell me you've decided you don't want it, after everything we went through to get it. It's not that. Then what? This is what you've craved ever since the chorus stripped it from you. Take your victory lap. I like the way you think, truly. I can only hope that somewhere Hades can see me. Sitting on his chair. I'm happy to do my part. Really. I know. And that makes what I have to tell you now all the more difficult. I lied. Even if we could find Freddy, you couldn't bring her back. The laws of death are not so easily circumvented.
And the Fates?
They will not help you or anyone. Even if you could speak to them, they will not care. And never have.
You didn't once consider telling me. I might have helped you regardless.
You, perhaps, but Apollo? I suppose we'll never know.
You know, for a moment, I thought you actually cared about me. Just a little bit.
Grace, I...
But you don't, do you? Not about me, not about Calliope, not about anything.
At the very least, I had hoped we might find your friend's spirit.
Why? We can't bring her back.
Not without great sacrifice, no. No, the rules of death are clear. Yet, you might have spoken to her. I know what it's like not to get the chance to say goodbye.
Queen of the Dead.
Hey.
Still glue cigarette for her.
You're here. Yeah.
Yeah, I've actually been watching you since you arrived. It's not like there's much else going on.
Fred, I know.
No. Don't even start, Grace. I made my decision. I don't regret it one bit.
I do. I want to go back. I want it all to go back. It's not supposed to end like this.
This isn't the end. Hey, it's not by a long shot. You still have a whole story to finish.
Without you?
Yeah. Without me.
I don't want to.
Well, I don't blame you. I happen to be really good company.
Hey, no. I guess this is it, huh?
Almost.
I found someone while I was down here. Someone you really need to meet.
Calliope? This... You can't be real. Your soul is inside Grace.
Is inside Grace. The rest of me... I'm here, Persephone.
And this is real. We need to know what happened to you, Calliope. How did you die? Why didn't you come to me? If you were in trouble, I would have protected you.
I know you would have. But I couldn't let you be drawn into Apollo's prophecy as well.
Apollo's prophecy?
He didn't tell me that. No, I don't suppose he could have. It's a long story.
Skip to the end. I want to know who sent the Furies after you.
Athena.
No.
It's true. Apollo delivered a prophecy to her that said I needed to die. Then she sent the Furies after me when I went to the reliquary. I barely escaped. I fled back to the mortal world. To you.
Why come to me? Of all the places you could have run to, why come to my apartment?
Because I was dying.
But I couldn't save you. I barely even knew you.
I was wandering the streets that night, wondering if I should go to the reliquary or just flee. And I heard you singing. I followed you home after to see where you lived. I didn't know what would happen to me, but I thought, just in case, I knew I had to hold out until I reached you.
I wish you hadn't. You didn't give me any choice.
I wanted to. I thought I would at least have time to explain.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't have believed you.
The Furies, they kept coming. It was all I could do just to reach you. I am so sorry, Grace. I truly did not mean for it to be like this.
Apollo hates using his power. Why would he have given a prophecy to Athena?
Because she demanded it. She was desperate.
How did you even find out?
Apollo was horrified after he delivered the prophecy, and he refused to stay silent. And he came to warn me. He was torn. Telling me meant I was locked into it. I still think he did the right thing. Though I expect he disagrees.
What was the prophecy? Surely I need to hear it.
If I tell you, you'll be locked into it, just like me.
But the prophecy doesn't just say you have to die. There's more to it, right? They always require interpretation.
Apollo told Athena that. He begged her not to jump to conclusions, but maybe she was right.
We don't talk about Apollo, no, 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 no. We don't talk about Apollo, no, 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 no.
It doesn't just involve you, does it? It involves me. It must, or you wouldn't hesitate.
Athena wanted to know if there was a way to save the idols. The answer was this. The idols cannot continue so long as the last muse lives.
And I'm the last muse.
And now you know the prophecy.
did you go to the reliquary? We know about the mirror, but
you wanted to annul the prophecy.
And the Fates are the only ones who could, if they would even help me. I doubted it, but I was desperate. I never got the chance to ask. Someone told Athena where I was going, and she must have realized what I meant to do.
But how did she get the Furies to attack you? They aren't pets. You didn't break any of the old laws.
I don't know. Maybe it's something the ruler of the Idols can do. But you'd have to ask Athena.
You went to Pan for the key to the reliquary, right?
Yes. He's the reason I knew about Nyx's mirror, actually. He told me about it long ago.
He told Medusa where you went. She, I expect, told Athena.
Oh. Pan couldn't have known what it would mean. I didn't explain.
That's it. You forgive him, just like that.
I'm sure he feels guilty enough, my love.
Athena's gonna pay for this. She will pay.
She wanted to save the Idols. And I wanted that too.
You weren't about to kill anyone to get it.
I have to go back. I have no idea what will happen. None of this seems real.
Thank you.
if returned.
You did it. You actually brought me back from the dead. Of course I did.
Did you get a chance to speak to the Fates?
No.
Then what happened?
I'm no longer an idol. Freddy is the muse now. That was the only way to bring her back.
Then you're not the last muse.
And you know why that was a problem, don't you? That's right. We learned about the prophecy, as well as all your lies. You knew. You knew the truth this entire time, even when you said you were helping Grace.
Yes. Yes, I did.
Is there more you haven't told me? Did you know about the Furies as well?
No. I didn't know how Calliope died.
But you knew Athena was behind it.
I thought I could nudge you in the right direction. Help you find the truth without learning about the prophecy.
Well, you failed. We know it now.
Well, then it's done. You're locked into it, as is Freddy. Athena will want her dead, too.
You're right. I actually hadn't considered that part.
I'm so sorry, Grace. I never meant for this to happen.
That's right. Leave. It's what you're best at. I don't know how this will affect your trial. We could tell them what we've learned. Even without proof, it makes enough sense that Athena couldn't just brush it off. You're not the last muse any longer. After all, your Freddy isn't on trial. Yet if Athena believes you both need to die in order to save the idols, she'll find a way. Then I'll just have to stop her, won't I?
Brave words for a mortal.
If I've learned anything, it's that idols aren't all powerful. Plus, I'll have help, right?
I lied to you, used you. And you still want my help?
I'd say you owe me.
I intend to keep my promise. We go to the trial and I'll help you, even if it means overthrowing Athena. Calliope would approve.
But what about?
Just so you understand, our chances aren't good. I suggest you do whatever necessary to prepare.
Great.
Okay, guys, I'm going to end it here. Like, share, and subscribe, and bye-bye.